Let's bring in Tom Homan, former acting ICE director. He's a Fox News contributor, and he knows all about this. He joins us live. Mr. Homan, it looks as if the first batch from batch of buses from the caravan now is here. Another 200 people are expected in the coming hours. What should we know?
Well, I think Brian said it right a few minutes ago, game on. I mean, I think the administration is ready. CBP has, of course, got a lot more resources down there, you know, with the military building the infrastructure and the fencing. You got a lot more inspectors and asylum officers down there from CIS ready to start these interviews if they come to a port of entry. If they decide to enter this country legally, of course, the president's proclamation is not going to be allowed to claim asylum. They're going to be metered in, and we'll work at the government's pace, not their pace. And hopefully, if these people do come to the United States, and they'll be detained until they see a judge. Because back in 2014, when this first started, when they were detained long enough to see a judge, more than 80% of them lost their cases. They got put on planes and sent home, which sent a strong signal to Central America, and the crossings depleted way low. So hopefully we can send another message. They'll get their due process, but if a judge orders them removed, they got to go.
All right, this was a headline in Politico. Trump considers tough-talking former ICE director for DHS chief. I remember when we first met.
Do we know a tough-talking ICE director?
Not yet.
I remember you saying that you tried to retire, and then the president called you and said, I need you to help me out with ICE, so you stayed on a little longer, then you retired again, and now he possibly, or there are headlines that say he could tap you as the new Homeland Security Secretary. What are your thoughts? Is that going to happen?
I knew you were going to ask me this question.
We had to.
Look, I'm not going to speculate on what the president's going to do. I think we got a strong secretary. I do. I worked with Secretary Nielsen for 7 months before I retired. It's a 24/7, 365 job. I mean, with the immigration, which, you know, 50% of America hates you 100% of the time. You can't win on this topic because it's so divisive, so controversial, so emotional. But I think she's working hard, doing a good job. And, you know, and we got a secretary that serves at the pleasure of the president. If the president's going to make a change, I mean, that's certainly his prerogative. But I really don't want to speculate what the president's going to do. I read the same story. My phone blew up last night. We'll just wait and see what happens. But I think we got a secretary in place now. I think we need to support her. I think she, when she was asked to step up, she grabbed the bat and stepped up to the plate.
Yep.
So all these people want to attack her all the time and attack this administration. I don't see them stepping up the plate. They got no metal, you know, and no fortitude. So she's working hard, and I just think we need to support her until a decision is made. So I'd like to stick with that.
I agree, too. And she's put up with personal turbulence herself and her own personal life once she left office. Nothing but respect for her personally. How do you feel about, on another note, now all of a sudden that term abolish ICE among progressives that use that to propel themselves into office and change the narrative and attack the president? They're backing away from abolish ICE. How do you feel about that?
You know, I don't know if they're backing away. They're changing their message, right? They know that with the help of Fox News and myself and the president, we're out there saying, look, abolishing ICE equals open borders, because if you get into the country illegally, no one's going to look for it to remove you, which is going to be a further enticement. You know, abolishing ICE is enticing people to come. Sanctuary cities entices people to come. So I think they got away from that because they knew it was a loser before the election. But mark my word, I think ICE is going to be they're going to be hit hard with budget. I think the House Appropriations, which will be under the control of the Democrats here soon, I think they're going to look to cut the ICE budget, which means they'll fund less beds, which equals less arrests and less deportations and more catch and release. I certainly think it's going to be a struggle with the House under Democratic control, because they don't want immigration enforcement, and the president can certainly shut down DHS because they're still in a continuing resolution, which is exactly what the Democrats, some of the Democrats, not all, but a lot of the Democratic leadership would love DHS to get shut down, because you're talking about Border Patrol and ICE. So I think we're in a tough spot, but I think they may not want to abolish ICE, but they're going to strangle them on funding.
Well, let's see what happens when they take control. Tom Homan, thank you very much. If the president calls, call us right back. We'll put you on TV, okay?
You got it.
Okay, thank you.